Howdy folks, welcome back to White Silence on SnowRunner. We are going to start out with the Kenny you see in front of you with the four spot bed that was formerly hooked up to the generator. We're going to haul 4 units of lumber with it. And then we're going to get long logs off of the other map to complete this job, wooden case. I swapped places with the Kras Chabors over there to run the generator. Let's make sure the generator is on. We're too far away from it. I can fix that. Now we are not too far away. I've been going back and forth from one map to the other, so understandable that the generator's not running, I guess. There's usually smoke out of the exhaust, but whatever. See, the side doors are open, the fan is spinning, the generator's running. Now let's change trucks and load for lumber. There we go. Let's see where we're going. Oh, that's right, way down by Stepanich's house. Could be tough getting our other stuff done. I've actually got 2 lumber on a truck down here, but doesn't really do any good when it's only 2. I need 4. All right, that should be good enough. There is a job to repair this bridge, but you have to do another job first. You know, that's always the case. So we'll just hustle through this as quick as we can. I would like to get that bridge repaired. There's a lot of work to do between then. South here, between what we're on now and getting to that bridge repair. We need long logs to go along with this lumber. And then we need short logs to go along with the next job. So rather than driving back and forth, I'm going to use the global map to jump from one region to the other. Except when I'm loaded, of course. A horse, of course. Or in this case, a Kenny. We're through. We're good. I didn't need to slam the brakes on. We were just approaching the corner, is all. There we go. If it starts pushing through the corner, just set the parking brake for a second. What is this doing? Did I miss a point? The downside of using waypoints. I really don't need to do this job. This is not the job that I need to do in order to do the bridge. In fact, there's really no reason to do this job except that it's something that needs to be completed. I could wait on it till later, but I was already set up to do the job, so here we are. The other part of this, the long log, I think after I do the next job, I'd be able to get long logs off of this map, but that's just a guess. So we'll just get that one long log off of the other map. Yeah, back there where the crash bars is where this goes. And where the long log goes. Of course. And here we are. Cargo management, 1, 2, 3, 4. Stage completed. And like I said, I would start using the global map system to get from one map to the other. I don't need to drive that truck over here. All I need do is jump in this truck. We still have to wait for the map to load, but we don't need to drive all the way over there. I currently have a short log trailer on this truck. I'll have to drop that one and grab a long log trailer. When I was customizing that truck and putting the trailer on it, I was thinking about the next job. Not this job, but the job after that I have to do in order to do the bridge. So, this I will just drop trailer, detach trailer. I will get over to where we're going and then purchase or spawn the long log trailer. Now this is the GGMS trailer that I was using as a bumper pole behind the Kenny, or Krasjors rather. Now, to get a long log, I'm going to do the GGMS gooseneck logs long. And then I will be right back. Okay. I don't know why I can't do that between videos. In fact, I haven't been recording. This is the same stretch of videos that I started at 1:30 in the morning. Only I haven't been recording for about 3.5 hours. I had breakfast and took a nap. Just left the game on. So. And why doesn't it? Put that on the trailer. Ah, shit, I think I had problems with these trailers. Yeah. These trailers won't auto load. Well, not that I want the bumper pull, but I know this one works. God dang it. Now it's still not auto-loading the trailer. Not enough space for auto-loading. That's what it's doing. See if we can give it enough space and get the gooseneck to work. I don't know what it means by not enough space. It was obviously, it obviously had no problem putting wood on the truck. Okay, maybe now it'll work. Now that it finally did the discover thing. Trying to go right down the other side of that other truck over there, and the thing is just not cooperating. Maybe I need to just slow down. Thank you. Well, okay, that time the bounce worked for me, I guess. I really don't like that truck sitting here. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, it bounced down flat to the ground. And it won't load. Won't load the logs. I don't get it. Hey, I'm straight with it now, and it won't load. Try one more thing. Get rid of that. Put this on. See if that makes a difference. Of course, I can't have it in there like that. Got the GGMS saddle on it. That might be affecting things as well. It ain't gonna work sitting all up there like that. Caught on the roof line. I wonder if it's because I got the two-spot basket on there. Who knows? Any stupid little thing could be doing it. doesn't like this truck, doesn't like the basket, doesn't like the saddle. Who knows? So looks like this, you know, my big plans for this episode are dog shitter. See the ball sticking up in the center of the fifth wheel? That's, configured for a dolly trailer. You can put that down and haul any normal semi-trailer. Oh, not the bumper pole. The gooseneck. I'll try that one. Look, down here it works just fine. Can't drive over those trees there. I was saying earlier that I knew if I had the GGMS saddle, there was a different trailer I could use rather than the bumper pole. But I had forgotten that it wasn't a fifth wheel trailer, it was a gooseneck. It was not really any more stable than a bumper pole, but here we are. Fuck's sake, the damage. Flat tire and a broken suspension. Fifty-eight more. I felt positive about getting all three jobs done until 20 minutes in when I can't load the long logs at the sawmill. discovered it again. Anything, this gooseneck dumps the shit easier than the bumper pole. Kenny's getting wild on the corner. You know, it isn't like there's a great big sign right there. Yeah, that's the salt. There must be a certain like hitbox on the ground where you know, inside the hitbox it'll let you load, outside the hitbox it's gonna say not enough room. back there at the sawmill I'm talking about. You know, on a long rig like this, you're going to gonna be too long for the hit bodies. Oh, it's not that way. Straight up to the other road. That takes me north. Take a right on the next road. Left on the road going that way. See, it was going to slide right into the sign until I tapped the parking brake. Then it turns. And this has to go around the corner and back up. Just like the last node. Wow. A whole episode to do one stinking little pass. Cargo management, one long log, and we did wooden case. Isn't that special? Yeah. Alright. Well, we don't need the long log trailer anymore. Say goodbye to the lonely trailer. We can take this to the garage. then we do map, global map, and oops, I forgot. Gotta retain if you want the truck to travel with you. And then go to the garage over there, and when it loads, I'll be able to get the truck back. But for this episode, I'm gonna call it right here. We'll pick up either bringing the short logs over, or maybe back on White River with doing the first two stages. The logs are the last stage of three or four stages on that job. So we might start back over there, but thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.